Do you ever feel like your child has low energy, they're irritable, and maybe has a hard time focusing, and you think to yourself, maybe this could be due to iron deficiency, or maybe you're a dairy-free home and you're worried about calcium, and potentially, maybe you've never given your children a vitamin D supplement and you wonder if that's a problem. One of the number one reasons parents reach out to me because they're worried about their children's eating habits. And ultimately their nutrition. It can be so difficult to get the whole spectrum of foods and nutrients into our children, especially if you're dealing with a picky eater. So I tend to focus on common nutrient deficiencies in children instead of obsessing over a longer list. In today's video, we're going to discuss the five most common nutrient deficiencies in our children and my suggestions to ensure everyone in your home is healthy and happy. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Jessica, and here on my channel, we focus on all things mom life, whether that's cooking or cleaning or taking care of our families, but everything we do here does have a bit of a healthy twist, as I am a holistic nutritionist and a nutritional practitioner. So if that sounds like something you might be interested in, I would love it if you would take 2 seconds, literally one, two, open up the description box down below and hit the big red subscribe button. It means a lot to me and a lot to YouTube. So let's jump into why we care about these nutrient deficiencies and what we can do to up your toolkit. Vitamins and minerals are needed for optimal growth and play many functions in the growing body of our children. Whether it's bone development or boosting the overall immune system, many of these nutrients work together and synergistically for maximum absorption. So when one of them is just depleted, it can really affect the function of the others. Making sure our little ones are getting what they need is crucial and also a big concern of parents. Hence why you clicked on today's video. Now I know there's always something to worry about, and worrying is, well, exhausting. So I want you guys to focus on the nutrients that really matter. So starting with these five common nutrient deficiencies, along with dietary sources, it really can help bridge those nutritional gaps that we might be dealing with. So let's jump into today's list. And the first one is definitely a big one, and that is iron. Iron is needed for so many functions in the body, and it's a component of hemoglobin, which helps to carry oxygen from the lungs to the rest of the body where it's used and stored. And it's extremely important for muscle function, which is why it is so crucial for growing children. So now that we know a bit more about iron deficiency, what are some of the symptoms you could expect from an iron deficient child? Well, deficiency in iron can be present in a number of ways. Many things like anemia, irritability, they could be lethargic, they could show some impaired cognitive function, poor feeding, and weakness. And here's a fun fact of the day. And as I said that, it didn't sound right, because this actually isn't fun. So here's a fact of the day. Iron stores start to diminish between 6 and 12 months of age, younger for premature or low-weight children. Yeah. So by 1 year old, your child is already starting to go through their iron reserves. And if a child is a picky eater with limited iron intake, appetite can be hindered, which further limits food consumption. So then you're stuck on this hamster wheel. So let's talk about some dietary sources of iron. So wonderful sources of iron are things like, of course, red meat. Then there's pasture-raised poultry, there's pasture-raised eggs, beans, lentils, dark leafy greens, and then seeds such as pumpkin seeds, sesame seeds, or something like tahini. If you're familiar with my work, then you know I think the best way to get iron and, well, most of these nutrients into your children is through a morning smoothie. You can toss in all of those dark leafy greens with some pumpkin seeds and some pineapple or strawberry. And why are we doing that? Well, because these foods are now rich in vitamin C. And when sources of vitamin C are paired with iron-containing foods, it improves their absorption. If you're interested in learning more about some of my favorite smoothies, I will link a video for you right up here. Feel free to check that out after you're done with today's video. The next big one on the list is gonna be no surprise to you, and that's vitamin D. It's another common nutrient that children tend to be deficient in, and it is crucial to the development of growing bones. So an adequate amount of vitamin D in children is so important, because then we're avoiding any malformities that may happen within the bones, such as rickets, other bone diseases, and things such as osteoporosis later in life that, well, could have been impacted as young as 2 and 3 years old. So it is often forgotten that vitamin D works together with vitamin K2 and magnesium. So vitamin K2 and magnesium aid in the absorption of the actual calcium. So without vitamin D, there is a chance that your child could also then be deficient in calcium. So without adequate vitamin D levels, there's a chance of, well, calcium deficiency or calcium being shunted other parts of the body, such as soft tissue, where it will calcify and actually cause problems. So vitamin D also plays a huge role. I'm sure you all know this, in immune function, and a deficiency in this vitamin may be involved in the development of certain allergies and diseases such as respiratory infections and even autoimmune diseases. So symptoms of vitamin D deficiency in children include things like frequent bone fractures, bone pain, muscle weakness, difficulty thinking clearly, and constant fatigue. So widespread vitamin D deficiency has also been linked to other epidemics such as autism, asthma, and diabetes, both type 1 and type 2. So some of the best dietary sources of vitamin D come from things like sustainable fish, egg yolks, beef liver, mushrooms, and almonds. Another wonderful way for children to get vitamin D is, well, to spend time outside, outdoors, getting sunlight. This will aid in the absorption of calcium and boost immunity. Since we don't get much sunlight during the winter months, it's so important to supplement to ensure children do not have this nutrient gap. I've mentioned this a few times in many of my morning routines, but direct sunlight absorption through the eyes first thing in the morning is one of our family's hands down favorite ways to boost our vitamin D levels. So be sure to check out this video after you're done with today's. So we couldn't possibly talk about vitamin D without this next common nutrient deficiency, and that is calcium. Calcium takes on many roles in our children's growing bodies, such as the development of strong bones and strong teeth, things like muscle function, heart regulation, and enzyme functions throughout the entire body, not to mention the transmission of messages through the central nervous system. If there's a lack of calcium entering the body, it will actually deplete calcium from their bones to use this nutrient for other functions. So the result is then you're becoming more susceptible to fractures and other things that are symptomatic of calcium deficiency. So speaking of symptoms, symptoms of calcium deficiency in children often result, they easily fracture bones, they have weak and brittle nails, they have muscle cramps or spasms, confusion or memory loss, and even that numbness and tingling sensation in their hands and their feet. And I hope you're ready now for the good news with calcium, is that your children don't need to be milk or dairy lovers to get enough calcium. Some great non-dairy dietary sources of calcium include things like dark leafy greens, so here we go talking about those smoothies again, wild-caught fish, things like canned wild-caught salmon or sardines with the bones in them, and then there's things like nuts and seeds such as almonds and sesame seeds. Moving along to the next common deficiency, and that is vitamin A. So vitamin A is needed for growing children's vision and protecting the eyes. Vitamin A is also used to maintain healthy skin, teeth, and bones, and it's extremely important for the integrity of cell membranes. It's worth noting that vitamins A and D need each other for proper absorption. So the Weston A. Prince Foundation describes it as there's evidence that without vitamin D, vitamin A can actually be ineffective or even toxic. But if you're deficient in vitamin A, vitamin D cannot be properly absorbed. So vitamin A deficiency can lead to long-term eye damage, night blindness, and even permanent visual blindness. So dietary sources include things like sweet potatoes, which is hands down my favorite way to get vitamin A into myself, into my children. Things like carrots, dark leafy greens, again, green vegetables, organ meats is another fantastic way to get this into your diet, and fish liver oil. So beta carotene found in things like carrots need to actually be converted to vitamin A, whereas things like beef liver, for example, 3 ounces of beef liver contains 27,000 IUs of vitamin A. To get that same amount of vitamin A from plants, assuming the 3% conversion that takes place, you would actually have to eat like 4.4 pounds of cooked carrots and 40 pounds of raw carrots, and then around 50 cups of cooked kale. It's pretty crazy, right? So you're better off opting for animal products like liver or grass-fed dairy, like things like butter, yogurt, milk, or cheese, which have significant amounts of vitamin A and there's no conversion needed. Our family consumes a quality cod liver oil to meet our vitamin A and D levels, amongst other nutrients. I've linked all of the supplements I've mentioned in today's video in the description box down below, so be sure to check that out. Moving along to vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 deficiencies are more and more common in children and adults, so those of you who are watching this, we should probably implement this advice as well. Statistically, it's showing that vitamin B12 deficiencies are definitely increasing. And this vitamin is essential for the formation of blood as well as cognitive and nervous system function. Vitamin B12 also helps make DNA, which is the genetic material that we are all made up of. So making sure our children's vitamin B12 levels are up to par is crucial, especially as deficiencies can lead to certain types of anemia and disorders that enlarge red blood cells. So symptoms of vitamin B12 deficiency include things like impaired brain function, weakness, irritability or lack of appetite, delayed growth or learning development delays. It's also connected to elevated levels of homocysteine in the body. Homocysteine can lead to several cardiovascular conditions as they get older. So dietary sources for vitamin B12 include things like grass-fed meat, pasture-raised poultry and eggs, sustainable fish, tempeh, seaweed, and a beautiful plant source of this is nutritional yeast. So now I want to hear from you. Have you ever wondered if your child was nutrient deficient? Let me know in the comment section down below. And for peace of mind, why not just get started today with some of the foods and recommendations that we discussed in this video? And if you have any questions, let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to have an open dialogue with you and troubleshoot any issues that you and your family may be struggling with. Thank you again for watching. If you liked this video, it means a lot to me if you give it a big thumbs up. And then be sure to hit that subscribe button. It's right over here on the screen now. That way you don't miss a single video, and I hope to see you back here next Thursday.